What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel of Makerfile. Today I'm gonna show you a DIY ZVS or zero voltage fitting flyback driver. Here's the schematics. I designed this thing with the Evo. It's not that much complicated. Here you have your DC input around 12 to 35 volts. This LED is just basically for power. Then here are your the gate resistors, this and this. Here the gate discharge resistor, the gate source over voltage protection, then the diodes, the two inductor chokes, and the parallel capacitors. And here you connect your inductor. If you're using it for induction heating, you just connect your air coil. Or for breaker flyback driver, you connect your primary winding here. So the MOSFETs are IRFP 250. I believe they can handle about that 3 amps and 200 volts. Yeah, they are perfect. Also, although I designed these capacitors, but the ones I found have a combined capacitors of like 3 microfarads. So this is a circuit, and here's the PCB layout. So here you have your power, and here you have your inductor or coil. Here are your capacitors, the inductor chokes, the MOSFETs, the resistors, the source discharge resistors, then the diodes, the LED for power. The same on the other side. These are the gate. These are the gate drain, fast switching diodes. I'm using UF4007. You can also use FR107 or FR207 or any other fast switching or fast recovery diodes. They are shown in the circuit. The gate resistance you should use once rated 1 watt and above, because below that they tend to get really warm. So here's the bottom layout, and I etched it using tunnel transfer method. And here is how it looks from the bottom side. And here is how it looks when it's complete. this coil, I was using it for some induction heating, and it worked well. So to use it for a flyback driver, you just connect it and connect the primary winding across these capacitors. I'm using these nuts, or you can just solder them, or use any other connector for ease of transition. So that's basically it. And so now, let's see it in action.
Yes, it is the normal ZVS. I'll give you the schematics later. So the MOSFETs are mounted of some small heat sinks, and I'm using IRFP 250N. The capacitors, the parallel capacitance is about 3.3 microfarads. So here is a flyback transformer core, which I rewound. The original secondary winding just got damaged. So the primary is made up of around 8 turns. Yeah, and for my power supply, I'll be using this Seasonic ATX power supply. It's a very powerful power supply with a capacity of around 600 watts. So I'm currently using the 12 volt line. So in this flyback, the secondary turns are around 950 turns, and the arcs from it are just amazing. So I'll be working on this heat sink. So I'll just turn it on and let's see what happens. So turn it on. Yeah, right now it's on. So let's do some arcs. Wow, a good very good aux. You can see how hot the arcs are. That is super white hot plasma there. You can feel them. You can hear the sound. The nail is getting red hot just after a couple of seconds. You can see. It's just amazing. I have to mention though that the MOSFETs get really warm after a few seconds of arcing. When the voltage drops to around 9 volts when I'm arcing. I will let it cool for a bit before I destroy my MOSFETs. So the MOSFETs are really warm. The MOSFETs are warm, almost too hot for touch. The inductors are really warm, as well as the capacitors, also as well as the primary core. The primary winding, I mean. The secondary winding is also stone cold. The only thing that seems to be getting hot are the MOSFETs. I don't know what's the reason, but maybe the heat sink are too small or it's drawing too much current. Probably I should use a fan to cool the MOSFETs. Let's do some more arcing. Okay, I'll turn it on. Now it's on, and let's see. Wow, look at that. It's just amazing. That plasma. Oh, you can hear the sound that it's making when it's arcing. This thing is definitely really powerful. Look at that. I mean, the arc starts forming from around 1 centimeter, and it can be stretched to well, like 2.5 inches. Yeah. Meaning it can deliver well over 60,000 kilovolts. You can see the nail is now starting to get red after just a few arcs. Okay, that's it guys. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel for more electronic for more electronic projects. See you next. Thanks.